Hello everyone, this is Vinti Rai. I'm going to teach you science of class 6. This is chapter 2. Chapter name is Components of Food. Book is opened in front of you. Now let's see. I will read paragraph one by one, then I will explain in a simple word. Let's see. In chapter 1, we made list of the food items that we eat. We also identified food items eaten in a different part of India and marked these on its map. See student, in an earlier video, I made many tables about the food items and about their ingredient. And also I taught you from where we get that ingredient. Most of the ingredient comes from plant. So I explained to you also about the part of plant. Now let's see. A meal could consist of chapati, dal and brinjal curry, and there may be rice, sambar and vegetable preparation of lady fingers. Yet another meal could be appam, fish curry and vegetables. Let's see student, this is the picture of a complete meal. Meal consists not only one food item, it consists at least three food items. See, when you take your lunch, then you don't eat only rice. You eat rice, dal, vegetable, at least minimum three items should be there in our meal. So this is the picture of a complete meal. In addition, we can take curd, pickles, chutney. These items also we can take, but it is in addition. These are compulsory items you can consider. Now see activity 1. Our meal usually have at least one item made of some kind of grain. Other item could be a dal or dish of a meat and vegetables. Just right now I told you our meal consists of three items. In that three items, one should be of grain and next second should be of any dal or meat. Meat item for the non-vegetarian and dal item for vegetarian people, and the third item should be vegetables. It may also include items like curd, buttermilk and pickles. Okay, these items also we take, but this comes in addition. Some example of meals from different region are given in table 2.1. Select food items you depicted on a map in chapter 1. Add some more meals to this list and enter this in table 2.1. See in this table 2.1, here states are mentioned here. Two states are given and their meals also are mentioned here. You will have to write some more states and about their meals. Let's see students, I have written here that table 2.1 and two states are mentioned already and their meals are given in your book. I have written four more state here and I have written about their special meals. See, Punjab is given in your book. The grain item in Punjab is used makki roti. Okay, in grain most of the people of Punjab use makki ki roti, and second item is in the form of dal, they use rajma dal. In vegetables they use or eat sarso ka saag. Now in others, mean to say in addition, they like to take curd and ghee. Most of the people of Punjab like to eat ghee. Now we will talk about the Andhra Pradesh. In Andhra Pradesh, most of the people take rice in a grain and two dal in dal item, kundru vegetable in vegetables and buttermilk and ghee. Now we will talk about Assam. In Assam, most of the people like to eat rice in grain. And in dal, they are also used to take tur dal. And in vegetables, they like to eat green beans, pudina chutney in others. See students, you don't be confused that people of Assam eat only green beans. Okay, they eat all the vegetables. I have taken only one example. Okay, most of the people, you can say most of the people of Assam likes to eat this vegetable. In Bengal, Rice is used in a grain. Masoor dal is used in dal item. And begun bhaja is also the famous vegetables in Bengal. In others, they like to eat kheer. In Rajasthan, bati in grain. Panchmel dal is used in dal item. And gatte ki sabji is in vegetables. Mirchi bada in others, they like to eat. In Gujarat, people like to eat rice, khatti mithi dal, batata bada and salad. So, such type I have completed this table. You also will write in your copy the same things. Sometimes we may not really have all this variety in our meals. If we are traveling, we may eat whatever is available on the way. It may not be possible for some of us to eat such a variety of item most of the time. Okay, let's see. It is not possible, students, all time we take a complete meal. Complete meal is very nutritious for our health, but maybe we are outside of our home, then that time won't be possible to take all type of meal. That time whatever will be available there, you just manage from that food items. It may not be possible for some of us to eat such a variety of item most of the time. Due to lack of money, it is not possible for all the persons. They take a complete meal all the time. Okay? There must be some reason though why meals usually consist of such a distribution. Do you think that our body needs different kinds of food for some special purpose? Now see, student, you also think why everyone recommend us to take a complete meal, because all the food items help our body to do their work. Okay, that's why we should take all types of food item. See, students, our next topic is what do different food items contain. So here we will study about the food items. We know that each dish is usually made up of one or more ingredient which we get from plant or animals. We should eat a proper meal, and each meal contain at least three food items. That is, you already have understand it. So here we will study about the food ingredient which comes from plant and animals. These ingredients contain some components that are needed by our body, and these components are called nutrients. The major nutrients in our body are named carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. Okay, see, our food items contain some components, and these components are called nutrients. And you already have heard about you should take all types of nutrients for proper body functions. So our body needs all types of nutrients. That's why we should eat all type of food. And the major nutrients which are present in the food items are called carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. Okay, now in addition, food contains dietary fibers and water which are also needed by our body. And in our food, along with these major nutrients, fiber and water are also present which are needed by our body. Do all food contains all these nutrients? Now one question is written here. All the food contain all these nutrients or not? Let's see. With some simple method, we can test whether cooked food or raw ingredient contain one or more these nutrients. This test for presence of carbohydrate, protein and fats are simpler to do as compared to test for other nutrients. Let us do this test and record all our observation in table 2.2. Now see, how will we find out our food item contain one or more ingredient, one or more nutrient? Okay, How will we find out? So for that, some tests are given in your book, and about the test of presence of carbohydrate, fat and protein are easy as compared to other nutrients like fiber. Okay, so the test of presence of carbohydrate, fat and protein are given in your book. For carrying out this test, you will need solution of iodine, copper, sulfate and caustic soda. You will also need few test tube and a dropper. So student, this is, you know, online classes, and we can't do this test in our practical form, but I will teach you what type of prop you should need for doing this test, and how will we do this test, I will try to verbally explain this all method. Okay, so for doing this test, we should need some solution of chemical, and that chemical will be iodine, copper sulfate and caustic soda. The formula of iodine will be I, you know this. This is the element, and copper sulfate is the compound which chemical formula is CuSO4, and caustic soda is also compound which chemical formula will be NaOH in chemical form. We tell this sodium hydroxide. Okay, now you will also need test tube and dropper for doing this test. Now try this test on cooked food item as well as raw materials. Table 2.2 show you a way to record the observation from this test. Some food items are given in this table, and you can conduct the test either with these or any other available food items. Do this test carefully and don't try to eat or test any chemical. Student, whenever you will do, you will get chance to do any test in practical room, then you should never use and test and eat the chemical, because that chemical will be harmful for our body and for our health. See, in table 2.2 here some food items are given, and in this food items some are raw and some are cooked. So you will take one by one each food item. For example, see, raw potato, if you will take, then you will do the test of presence of starch, presence of protein and presence of fat. You will take test of presence of all these nutrients, and those will present in this raw potato, then you will write yes in their column. For example, here starch is present in raw potato. So after doing test, when you will know which nutrient is present in this raw material, then you will write yes in their column. If for example in milk protein is present, so I have so yes is written in protein column. Okay, such times we will take test on these all food items, and we will complete this table. If the required solution are not available in ready-made form, then your teacher can prepare them as given in the box. Now see, here one box is given, and in this box the method is given for making solution of that chemicals. A dilute solution of iodine can be prepared by adding a few drop of tincture iodine to a test tube half filled with water. You can't do, teacher will make this solution. So for making this solution, very easy, only chemical and water you will mix in a test tube. In the same method, copper sulfate also you will take and some water, but yes, exact quantity are given. So with this quantity we will make this solution. Which chemical are given here, we will take that chemical and we will mix with water with given quantity, then solution will be ready. Let us begin by testing different food items to see if they contain carbohydrates. There are many types of carbohydrate. The main carbohydrates found in our food are in In the form of starch and sugar, we can easily test if a food contains starch. So students, we know all many types of carbohydrates are present, but the main type of carbohydrate which is present in our food, that is starch. So in the place of carbohydrate, we will take test about the starch, because main type of carbohydrate which are present in our food, that is starch. That's why in your table, in the place of carbohydrate, starch is written. So students, now in next video I will teach you all the test method for presence of starch, protein and fat. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.